to us, these people coming to conferences are highest spenders, so they're spending over $300 a day. It's also an opportunity to get people into the region for the first time around a conference that may not have been here for some time. It's really good at helping to increase our awareness and driving repeat visitation as well. And we set a target for the year of 10%, and you'll see here that the result for the year in December is at 7%. So looking at the data sitting behind us, what it shows us is that we've still had the same number of conferences and events go on in our region during that period. The only difference is we've got less people attending. So the conference sizes are smaller than what they were previously. So hence why we've had a decrease there, or we're not meeting our target. The other thing that's happening within this sector is highly competitive. So we're seeing Christchurch come back on stream. We're also, as we go forward, the sector will get more and more competitive for us. We've got national convention centres planned to be built in Auckland. We've got convention centres planned for Wellington, Christchurch, and Queenstown. So, you know, when most of the audience for conferencing is New Zealand based, we only attract a few of international conferences. We've got these facilities that we have to fill, but we've got a really strong competitive market out there. So it's good to see, as I said, the number of events, just these people attending. For us too, it's also about encouraging our own residents within our region to conference at home and hold their meetings and conferences in our region as opposed to going elsewhere. The third indicator there around visitor expenditure for the domestic market, as you saw from the graphs, we're very much just on trend. What's happening there, we have obviously had some challenges domestically to extract more value out of our domestic visitors. Part of the goal of this tourism opportunities plan is to identify how we can get domestic visitors spending more time and more money with us while they were here. Internationally, as you will have heard from me, in the last 2 or 3 years, our international story has been really strong, and we've got really strong growth in international visitor expenditure. So, you know, we're up 16 points based on an index well above the New Zealand trend there. Growth in website traffic, good result there, over 500,000 visitors to our website these days. And in terms of industry contribution, so private sector investment in our activities, we set a target for the year of 400,000, and for the first half of the year we had already received 320,000 of industry investment. Cash investment into our activities, and we are forecasting that we will meet that target for the year end. So really quickly, just working through the activities for the 6 month period to December, we start July, August with a large campaign into Australia with Tourism New Zealand and our neighbouring regions. That campaign is in planning mode for the next financial year and will kick off again in July and August based around the Central North Island touring proposition. We ran two domestic campaigns as well, Explore Your Own Backyard, focused on our own local residents, getting them out and about to enjoy what we've got to offer, and also a short escape campaign based on the outdoor environment, walking and cycling as well. December, we produced our regional visitor guide, and then we have recently launched a new mountain biking cycling digital portal, which we have been working on for the last 18 months to 2 years. In partnership with our Central North Island Regional Tourism Organisations. So you may recall me speaking about this some time ago. We wanted to position the Central North Island as the place for cycling and mountain biking. 8 regional tourism organisations have pooled our resources to provide this portal, a one-stop shop for everything you need to know to make coming into our region to cycle and mountain bike easy. So itineraries there, accommodation that's bike-friendly, cafes that are bike-friendly, and also information about each of the rides and who the target audiences are. It's been quite a project to get this up and running, as you can appreciate, across 8 RTOs, but we did launch that just in January this year, so I encourage you to go and have a look at that website. Nicola, as I said, coming on board as our development manager, and we commenced our tourism opportunities plan, which is this key piece of work, which will identify our current product offer, what we need to do to strengthen and enhance that offer, where there's an opportunity for new product and new investment into our sector. It's a long-term strategy, but it will provide the work plan for us and Nicola in this space as we go forward, the sorts of projects we will be looking to work on and partner with other people on. So that project, as I said, kicked off in December. We had consultation change March draft plan came back to my board last week. We're looking to send that out for feedback in the next couple of weeks, with having that completed in May. Just to give you an example of how we will be looking to partner in this area as we go forward, we've also completed a small project with Sanctuary Mountain Mamatotere. So ourselves, in partnership with Department of Conservation, Regional Council, Waitau District Council, have recently completed a small piece of work which looks at the current visitor experience and how they can increase visitor numbers and increase revenue. So that's the sort of partnership work that we'll be looking to work with others on as we move forward to specific projects where we've got key assets, could be potential key icons for our region, what is needed to take them from here to here. And so that work has just recently been completed there. And then we also, for the first time, have been undertaking our own primary research into the domestic market. So this is all a result of the additional funding that we have received to better understand our domestic visitor. We mostly rely on central government data, so it's not often we get the opportunity to do something specific primary research for our own region. And so that domestic research is underway. That will inform our domestic marketing campaigns as well as our product development. So it's going to tell us more about what our domestic visitors are wanting, why they're coming to our region, what we're wanting, the demographic profile, the sorts of activities that we're wanting to engage with, and of course that will inform strategy and investment. Tourism opportunities plan, I've actually just probably covered that off. As I said, we kicked off in December. What have I got on here? So in terms of the first draft that's come back to us last week, setting visions is always an interesting exercise. We had a workshop here down in South Waikato, and there's also a conference call with His Worship and with Craig here. And the vision is coming back where it's really starting to focus on putting the Red River at the centre. So both from a physical perspective, but also from a metaphorical, you know, being the lifeblood of our region, there's a whole range of tributaries, but this region's connection to the Waikato River, we're wanting to really lift that up in terms of the focus of tourism for our region. In terms of positioning, we're talking about journeys. Because we start to spread our region, it's all about different journeys, different stories and different journeys, where we encourage people through drive itineraries and bits and pieces to really get out and explore. So that's what that's all about. It's also talking about, what about hero experiences? What do we have across the region that's driving visitation? What do we need to do to further strengthen those hero experiences? But where is there an opportunity where we've got emerging experiences who may be in their infancy, but with a bit of support, development and potential investment that could become hero experiences over time? And that's what this plan is helping to identify. And where have we got opportunities for kind of greenfields, new development? So that's the hierarchy of what the plan is focusing on. Drive theme activities that I've talked about. And in terms of your products, there obviously the Blue Springs, the River Trails are very much in there. But also from this district's perspective, with the developments of Tokoroa, and the whole thinking around health and wellbeing and spa. There's also some concepts in here around bringing agri tourism to life, cultural tourism, certainly from the Kingitona sort of aspect. So those are just some insights into what's in that draft plan. As I said, we're working to get that a little bit more finished, and then we'll be looking for some feedback on that. And then just lastly, to finish off here, here's just some screenshots from the Ride NZ portal that, as I said, went live a couple of months back.
Well, we have to say that in 7 years you've been there, and tourism has, you know, now it's grown, and you're now an established part of our region. So congratulations, you're leading a healthy organisation. Any questions? Councillor McGill, then Councillor.
I live in nearby the Hotel. And I've been to Tokoroa for 2 years, especially in the current downturn of the dairy industry. A significant number of dairy farms have converted part of their house or houses for bed and breakfast. And they're getting phenomenal capital return. And, you know, $340 a night or something for mum and dad and a couple of kids and feed and have a look around the farm, that sort of thing. And I just noticed that you